Hello friends, today plant pathology basics part 2 video. If you didn't subscribe our channel, click the subscribe button. Already I had made plant pathology basics part 1 video. If you didn't watch, please watch it. In this video we are going to see very basics parts you have to know in plant pathology. Okay, shall we go for the video? First you have to know what is disease. The term disease comprises of two words, dis and is, which literally means uneasiness. Okay, what is plant disease means some abnormal condition that happened in a plant which alters the appearance or function of the plant. Okay, that's all. Downy mildew, powdery mildew, rust, wilt, smut, etc. These are some examples for plant disease that we will see in further videos. Okay. If you are studying plant pathology, you must know about broken tulips. Okay, broken tulips is nothing but it's a beneficial viral disease. Okay, in Holland, due to viral infection, broken tulips disease get occurred. So that the price of the diseased flower get high market price. Okay, because of its beauty, that much beautiful that flowers are. Okay, you can see in this picture how beautiful the broken tulips are. Okay. These broken tulips are beneficial viral disease. Okay, what is disease triangle? This is nothing but it comprises of three components of a disease. They are pathogen, host and environment. Pathogen is a tiny entity that causes a disease. Okay, a pathogen that causes disease must be virulent. Okay, disease causing pathogens are called virulent. Okay, important is the pathogen must be virulent. Okay. Next, what is host means? The organism that supports the activity of parasite. It should be susceptible. Environment factors should be favorable. Such factors are predisposition factors. Okay. This is triangle. It comprises of three components: pathogen, host, and environment. Environment should be favorable, and environmental factors are called predisposition factors. Okay. This is very important question. Okay. Next, Stevens and Van der Planck recognize time as a fourth factor in disease triangle, so that this is called disease tetrahorn. Okay, then disease pyramid consists of fifth factors as man. Okay, that is human being as fifth factor, that is called disease pyramid. This is disease tetrahorn. It comprises fourth factor time. Okay, how we will identify the plant is infected? By seeing the symptom. That's why it is a visible effect of a pathogen. Okay. Next, sign. Sign is nothing but visible structure of the pathogen produced in or on the diseased tissues. Symptom and sign, the major difference is symptom is visible effect and sign is visible structure. Okay, it is frequently asked objective question. Okay, the four main categories of symptom are color change. First, we will see about color change. This is the most common symptom. And verdant means what now? The diseased portion with accumulation of green pigment. The diseased portion will be accumulated more with the green pigment, that is verdant. Next, chlorosis, you all know very well. In chlorosis, the green pigment may disappear entirely and that place will be taken by yellow pigment. Simply yellowing of the leaf or plant, that is chlorosis. Okay. Next, the chlorosis that occurred due to the lack of light, that is under dark condition, is called etiolation. Okay. These are the important terms you must know. In color change, okay, and you can see chlorosis in this picture, that is yellowing of the leaves, that is green pigment is completely replaced by yellow color. You can see etiolation in this picture. Due to the lack of light, this condition occurs. Okay, symptom of yellowing and elongation of stems are leaves. This is etiolation. Next, albinism. First, what is albinification? Is it is nothing but the process of complete repression of the color. That is, there will be no color. That is albinification. The state or condition of being that albino is albinism. Okay, that's all about albinism. Next, chromosis. Chromosis is nothing but chroma means itself color. The word itself indicate. That is nothing but the green pigment is replaced by some other colors. That is red or orange. In this picture, you can see the albinism condition of a plant. That is albino. We all familiar with the term necrosis. That is, necrosis indicates death of the tissue. How the death of the tissue occurs means first the protoplast get degenerates and then death of the tissue takes place. It is necrosis. Okay, very important objective question. Coming to lesionecrosis. Lesionecrosis is nothing but the necrosis symptom expressed before the death of the protoplast. That is lesionecrosis. Okay. Next, hydrosis is nothing but the appearance of water-soaked transplant tissues. That is, the water-soaked transplant tissues contain some liquid. That is hydrosis. Okay, must be clear in that. Next, holonecrosis is nothing but the necrotic symptoms are expressed after the death of the protoplast. Okay, after the death of the protoplast is holonecrosis. Before the death of the protoplast is lesionecrosis. Okay, can easily remember these two. These are the types in necrosis. Can see the necrosis symptom in this picture. Clearly it is given. Okay, next, hypertrophy and hyperplasia. That is due to overgrowth, these symptoms occur. First, hypertrophy. It is nothing but the increase in size of the individual cells. Okay, increase in size. It is very important in hypertrophy and it is a very important objective question. Next, the increase in number of the cells as a result of cell division is hyperplasia. That is increase in number of individual cells. You must be clear in these two definitions because they are frequently asked objective questions. Please note it down in some other paper or something so that you will never forget it. Okay. Can see the hypertrophy symptom in this picture. Okay. That is increase in size of the individual cells. That is hypertrophy. Next, hypoplasia. It is under development. Okay. That is hypo means under. Okay. There is a reduced development of the whole plant. The tissues does not develop. That condition is called atrophy. Okay, you can see the hypoplasia in this picture. The underdevelopment of plant tissue and organs due to small production than the normal cells. Okay, that is dwarfing, stunting. The symptoms will occur. Next, causes of plant disease. You all know that pathogen only cause a plant disease. Okay, that is what is pathogen? Any agent that make the plant to suffer. If that is only cause a pathogen or incident or causal organism. The study of the cause of the disease, that is the study of the causal agent of the disease and its relation to the susceptible plant is etiology. Okay, it is very important question, very important objective question. They will ask what is etiology. Next, what are the two agents that cause the plant disease? They are categorized into two, that is living and non-living, living or animate or biotic agents. It includes eukaryotes, prokaryotes, mesobiotic or non-cellular organisms. Eukaryotes, prokaryotes difference you all know very well. Eukaryotes include fungi, algae, etc. And prokaryotes include bacteria, spiroplasm, phytoplasm, etc. Next, mesobiotic or non-cellular organisms include viruses, viroid and virusoids, etc. Okay. Panurogamic parasites is nothing but the Striga, Cuscuta, these are all things. Okay. About these all things we will see deeply in another video. Okay. Just note it, what are the biotic agents that cause a plant disease. Next, coming to non-biotic, there is a non-living or inanimate or abiotic agents. These inanimate or abiotic agents cause mineral deficiencies or toxicities. For example, Kyra disease of paddy is due to zinc deficiency. Okay. Next, toxicity of pesticides. It is otherwise known as iatrogenic disease. Okay. Other names you must know clearly. Okay. Next, temperature, moisture, light and air pollution. These are also cause disease. Okay, that's all about today's video. If you didn't subscribe our channel, subscribe it. Telegram channel link is in description box. Thank you.